So we have a long history of yellow perch fisheries in Lake Michigan. I mean, it goes back maybe thousands of years, but you know, the commercial fishery as it was really, I think, peaked in the mid 20th century, 1980s, lots of perch coming out of Lake Michigan and really fueling an interest in people eating perch. Our status today, though, it is very different than it was historically. We have very few yellow perch in Lake Michigan. We still do have a small commercial fishery in Green Bay, about 100,000 pounds of perch being harvested commercially every year.
We are so far behind that everybody could be in perch business or walleye or trout, and we would never be able to feed the demand.
Our aquaculture industry is really kind of land-based, not in public waters, especially for perch. They've dug some ponds on their property and they're growing perch there.
The whole idea about aquaculture is to have greater amount of success based on greater amount of hatching and survival and feeding and so forth.
The starting point of raising yellow perch is with the skein, and that's the gelatinous substance and that contains all the eggs. It protects them.
When I'm looking for eggs, I can walk around and pick out eggs that look better. If you're buying eggs, anytime you see a ribbon that has nice water-hardened yellowish color, they're pretty well fertilized. If you see some that are white, they're no good. All you have to do is collect the eggs in the spring, and they're going to be only one time a year. You can move them anywhere you want, in other ponds or indoors, and then hatch them out. And when they start growing, if people need them for stocking or grow out as food fish, you've got them. You've got everything you had out of one small little pot.
That's the easy part, is having the skeins and just kind of waiting for them to hatch. The hard part comes when they first hatch out. You have to feed live feed, because yellow perch are born virtually blind. And then once you get them accustomed to that, about a day after post-hatch is when you start, then you can start introducing powder feed. And then eventually when they get big enough, you can introduce pellet feed. We are raising the perch from eggs to a fingerling status, which is about 3 inches. An indoor facility is really beneficial for raising yellow perch, just because we can control environmental factors that we wouldn't be able to outdoors. They're a very fragile species, yellow perch, so being able to control things like dissolved oxygen, the water chemistry and temperature is very beneficial to prevent mortality.
When I get the feed trained fish, they're approximately 2 inches long. They've gone through a 3-week feed training process. So they're pretty solid on feed at that point. The majority of our fish sell between 5 and 7 inches. There are some overachievers in there that get up around 8 or 9 inches also, but the vast majority of the fish in a year and a half will be that 5 to 7 range. Those fish primarily are going to people to stock lakes and ponds around Wisconsin and in the UP.
I like to sell the eggs to people who are hatching them and growing them out. Then when they're fry, I'm doing a lot of feed training. I'm hoping that all the feed trained fish that I have, and these are going to be premium fish, go to people who want to grow them out. The fish that aren't going to be grown out or aren't feed trained, I will sell them as stockers, because there's a huge demand for fish stocking in ponds and so forth.
I think in general, a lot of these folks, a lot of these farms, they're, you know, it's small family businesses. They're doing something that they love. They really enjoy growing perch. They have an interest in, you know, perch as a species, and they're, you know, growing them on a fairly small scale, but producing an interesting product that people, you know, really want locally. What I hear from fish farmers in Wisconsin is, you know, they've got the fish, they can sell the fish. Where I'm at, it's why can't we grow more fish?